I'm Ted Scambos. I'm the lead scientist at the National Snow and Ice Data Center. That's a part of the University of Colorado. Landsat 8 is part of a revolution of how much remote sensing can do to track the polar areas. And of course, polar areas are really experiencing the brunt of climate change on Earth right now. Even though it might be hard to tell whether an area has gotten warmer or cooler from weather data alone, because it's really noisy, the glaciers can tell you that over the last decade or two decades or three decades, a certain area has become warmer or drier than it used to be. We measure the ice flow using pairs of Landsat images. We can see crevasses and other features move from high to low spots in Antarctica. What areas have changed since the 1970s and what areas are changing just in the last few years. Often the ocean around Antarctica will show small areas that are warmer, and right near the ice shelf, any amount of heat in the water is an indication that the ice could be melting. That event right there, that accelerated flow from land into the water, is the part that's doing the biggest fraction of contribution to sea level rise right now. And if we are going to see some of these extreme rates of sea level rise and levels like 2 and 3 feet in 100 years, it's going to be because glaciers have accelerated in Greenland, Antarctica, and they've melted in all of the glacier areas on Earth. So yeah, we want to track all of this and in near real time, because lots of folks are concerned or conducting research in how the world's icy areas are changing. They really are the harbingers of global climate change, and in the Arctic especially, they're showing huge effects of climate warming. So together, Landsat is a part of this emerging story where we have lots of ways of studying exactly how climate change is progressing in the Arctic and the Antarctic. We're going to have a lot of data to work with, and really it's going to be up to new graduate students, new young scientists, to figure out what clever ways you can put together all of this information and extract something out telling us about, you know, what's going on deep within the snow, or whether or not dust or soot are beginning to contaminate an area and darken it and make it easier to melt. All of those things, I think, are addressable with Landsat playing a role, but probably in concert with other satellites.